Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot, and we are back building our Isla Nublar Botanical Gardens. We are currently just moving over our Pachycephalosauruses. I think that one's in the process of being shot in the face. Where are you? Look, there we go. We've got two in there. Oh, and she goes pretty bloody quickly. Let's get her shifted over as well. So we have two Pachycephalosauruses, four Dracorexes, a Triceratops, and two Ankylosaurs, I believe. And that is our Hill Creek exhibit over here in the northern part of the park. And you know, you can kind of just look at it without gates and stuff. It's really nice. The feeders ruin it. I'm really still begging that we get the ability to not use feeders in the upcoming update. But we shall see. At least on the sandbox mode, you know? Not in the actual game, but in the sandbox. Because I'd love to have not have a feeder that the dinosaurs just roaming around, not so centered in one location. But yeah, it still looks like we just cut that bit out, ignore the smoke, put your hand over the bit where the smoke is, and it looks great. Anyways, what are we doing today? Well, today we are going to work on this bit over here to the right-hand side. This is going to be our sort of aquatic zone. Don't know why I have to say zoon, but it's a zoon sort of thing. So we need some dinosaurs if we're going to do that. And let's start off with a fan favourite with Suchomimus. Now, what is the best Suchomimus? That is the question. First of all, we're going to up its lifespan a little bit. Immune response, brain ageing, and reaction speed. Brain aging again, and we actually speed. Okay, cool. That is a very low percentage right there, and we're gonna add some cosmetics now. We want two. Which are the best ones? The jungle one's pretty cool. It's a bit edgy. It's a little bit, you know, 16-year-old who loves Hot Topic, but it's still pretty cool. So let's grab that. And I actually really like the default one, so I think that's what we're gonna get as well. I regret the jungle one already. I don't think it suits the aesthetic that I'm going for. It's too edgy. I want something more. We can't cancel it because in the next update you're going to be able to cancel incubations. So that's going to be really cool, but we can't do it yet. So somebody also had the idea, and I actually really like this idea. We're going to shut the park just for now because the park is being built. We're in the construction stage. Yes, they opened Jurassic Park before the park was finished, but you know, Jurassic World, I'm sure, didn't open when all they had was Main Street and one exhibit. I'm sure they waited a little bit. And I like that idea, so that's what we're going to do. Now, let's start working on this area on the right-hand side, our big old aquatic zone. Complete. Just going to cover this in as much water as possible so we know what we're working with. I've immediately realised the folly of my ways in that I can't put that over water, so we can't do the water first. We have to do the path. No. Have to do the path first. Top tip, right, let me try something. Yeah, you should put water, like, flatten your Isla Nublar, put water in and flatten it around that level, because every time I put water in, the ground kind of bumps up a little bit, as you can see right here, and it's proving to be very annoying. What I should do, and what I will do before my next playthrough of whatever we build on this park, is I will cover the entire thing in water and remove that water, and that way this will stop being an issue. So just, if you're intending to make your own flat Nublar, just a little tip there. So, just the tip. Let's grab ourselves a path. Let's grab this one. Bring it down. By what are you possibly obstructed? You can't be obstructed by the fence. That doesn't make sense. Doesn't make sense. No, that'll do. Right. And I think the idea is just to have this sort of curl right. I don't know. I'm having a think. I need three exhibits. That's the idea. So how do we do that? I kind of want to have like a little, maybe a viewing area in the middle as well. So maybe we'll build around that. That's probably a good idea. Let's try that. Okay, I want this to be perpendicular with this. So from about there and up that way straight. This doesn't have to be perfect. I know I'm saying those words out loud and it's very upsetting. And it's upsetting for me as well, but it's true. Nope, disastrous. It's all gone, nope. I'm gonna have to restart that. Okay. Perpendicular, in the middle, up, nice and straight. Zoom in a little bit. Make life easier. Okay. So this is the technique to get yourself a... Oh, I've messed it up again. You'll see why in a sec. I am so sorry. Okay, so this is the technique to get a perfect circle. And I'll show you why I've been messing up. You need to do like this first. You need to get those in, yes, but you also need to get the middle bits in, otherwise you're going to lose the middle point when it comes to extending it, and then we extend all these out by 3. Total. Okay, and then we get a nice curve, and we just stick all these together. Like so. Does that look weird to you guys? It looks weird to me. Why would that be anything other than perfect? Is this uneven somewhere? Why do I feel like this is uneven somewhere? What's going on over there on the left? What is this? That bit there is the only bad bit. If we get rid of that and get rid of that, and that's everything completely messed up, so cool. I can just do it like this. There we go. Look at that. Beautiful. Right, so that's going to be like a viewing area in the middle, and the three exhibits are going to kind of spiral off there somewhat. I don't know. We're going to stick some path down and see what happens. I'm going to have one of them here, like right by the shopping center as well, which I think will be pretty cool. Okay, so that'll be one, and then this path has to come forward through here. What are you hitting? A little bit of fence. Okay. And then, I kind of like the idea of it crossing over. Does that make sense? I have no idea. It should just feel wibbly and wobbly, you know? And I think at the very least, it feels quite wibbly wobbly. It's also definitely a little weirder than I expected it to be. Okay, and the final exhibit is just going to be the smaller one up here. Okay. Okay, it might look weird now, but it will look cool. Maybe, possibly, hopefully, probably not. But we're going to try, right. So we need to cover this in a nice fence. We'll use heavy steel, because these are large dinosaurs. I'm trying to avoid electric fences, generally speaking, because I don't think they suit the aesthetic. Okay, we'll have to do this one first, and then we'll bring in the Sucumimus, because I feel like the Sucumimus is the smallest of the three. Just in terms of, you know what, no, we're going to put the Baryonyx in this one, because I don't like the Baryonyx that much. So, Sucumimus, come on, friendo, let's go. This is the edgy one. This is Hot Topic Camimus. Sucumimus, more like you Sucumimus, because it's edgy and like insulting to people, yo. Good one, Sucumimus. Whew! Whew! Chills. Chills, buddy, chills. I do really like it. Even if it is totally edgy. And let's shoot it in the face. Let's get another one. And we all know what the basic one looks like. Alright, let's just quickly go make this a little bit more appropriate for a dinosaur, perhaps. Right, this is a good thing about the fence rather than path at the edges. You can get the water right up to the edge, which is very cool. Look at that, right up to it, amazing. Absolutely bloody soaking it is. Right, and we wanna, of course, try to, we need to give it some land because we're gonna need to give it a feeder, for example. So let's get the feeder in now. I don't want a goat, I don't think a goat's gonna be appropriate here. I'm just going to add some islands in, and I'm going to cut these in a little bit. We do want it to be primarily water. And we'll add some trees and stuff to give it a better look. It should feel like islands, you know? Okay, cool. And get some trees and stuff. Many trees, especially on that middle island, that's where they'd grow. Maybe a little portion down here, just build it up in little areas. Fade out over to that left hand side. That's a bit too much there. A bit more like that, maybe. Yeah, pretty cool. I really like this thing about having like just these big watery exhibits that you're gonna be able to walk through. I think when we get all of them in, it's gonna look really cool. There we go. Pretty happy with that. Let's get them ship shaped over. Boop. Oh. Okay. Well, there's my home screen. I clicked on my second monitor by accident and shunted me back onto my home screen. I don't think there's anything bad there. Well, I think all you saw was BBC Sport, which is okay. I can live with that. Right, Sucumimus done. Let's get ourselves our Baryonyx and we'll do the small one next. I don't love the Baryonyx in this game, I've got to say. I don't really know why. I just don't love the design or anything really, but it's It's one of the few dinosaurs I don't actively adore, so that's okay. Immune response. Reaction speed. Reaction speed. Brain aging. Right, I just want to double check this one. It is brain aging, right? Nope, no, it's not. Oopsie daisy, made a mistake. And colouring. What colours do we want? Let's go what I wanted with the other one. We want kind of like a wetland, wet tundra-y. What colour is the rainforest one? It's blue, but is it really blue? Are they ever really blue? Let's get a rainforest. And let's get... I think the default is actually a pretty... I don't know. I want like a green one. Like a wetlands one. Coastal. I was hoping for a woodland. Which is what we should have done for the Sucumimus as well. But no. Edgelord Sucumimus it is. So this one over here on the left is going to be the Baryonyx. Let's get to fencing. The journey begins once more. That's more like it, right? We just need to kill this little bit over here. Sorry, a little bit. You have died. But hey, you lived a good life. You're alive like a good... You're like fruit fly kind of levels. Okay, it's fine, guys. It's fine. Don't worry about it. If I'm not worried, you shouldn't be worried. Let's go. Let's bring that down to about there and then cut across. Bam. That'll do, donkey. That'll do. How are we over there? That's a little bit messy. Can I fix that? It's optimistic, but we'll give it a good old college try. I think that's as good as it's gonna get, and we aren't it. Oh, I've made it worse. I've made it all so much worse. Oh, you know what? That'll do. That'll blimmin' do. Right. Lord have mercy on me. Let's set this up then for our Baryonyx. Not as good as the other one, but I don't like the Baryonyx, so that's fine. And some of you love the Baryonyx, I'm sure, and that's okay. Please don't take it personally that it's not my favourite dinosaur. I want to mix these up a little bit in terms of... Can I give this one a little bit of a hill? I say a little bit of a hill. I made an absolute massive mountain in the middle. Let's knock that down a little bit. I don't know. Oh, I like that, though. Maybe even have it join in... Yeah, oh, I like that. That's pretty cool. Maybe even do, like, a little... No, that's not going to work. I still think we need, like, smaller terrain tools, you know? Oh, I thought that was going to look really cool. Ooh, shiny. Yeah, I think we don't need much more than that. I think that's pretty cool. Don't know how I'm going to put the feeder in here, but life will find a way, folks. Life will find a way. It's too much forest. Tell you what, we'll do a little extra bit somewhere and we'll just stick the feeder on here. There we go. Feeder. Lovely stuff. Lovely stuff. Right, Baryonyx, are you ready for your new home? Hoping for a cool pattern. Spooky. Let's take a look at him. Barry, how you doing, Bowser? I just don't know what it is about the Baryonyx. Why do I not love it? There's something about it that bugs me. I just cannot put my finger on one of this. Yeah, this one's better. That's very much the colour scheme I've been looking for. Very cool. Right. One to go. Spinosaurus. Spin. Right, let's get some colours on here. Reaction speed, let's just set all those nice and quick. Defense, brain aging. This one is immune response. Reaction speed. Oh, it's gonna be a low one this. Whoosh. Can't go much lower than this, actually. So let's just set cardio strength and a colour. Now I'll give it a 99% chance now. Oh, we've already got the colour on, never mind. Wetland! That's definitely the one we want. And... I do like the vivid. Yeah, we're going for colourful and bright, but I really like rainforest as well. Okay. I'm not happy about it, though. This one, right? Yeah. Collecting asset. Okay, folks. Asset. One to go. How am I going to do the fence for this one now that I think about it? Just kind of put it around here. Yeah, we can do that. We can just do this whole area. It'll have a substation in there. We can even build the fence around the substation. Not a big deal. So, let's get blimmin' work. Straight. Nice, nice. Something like that. Just kind of cut that area out. Very slick indeed. Slicker than a... I can't make that joke. Slicker than a water slide. Yeah, there we go. That's the stuff.
Assets in the air.
Okay. What's this fence doing? What are you doing, son? Get out of here. Get out of here.
Asset transportation underway.
I know if I go too far forward there, I won't be able to curve it around. You kind of start to get a feel for it. I say that, you know, it's been going disastrously, but you do start to get a feel for how this should be done. Oh, look at that, beautiful. It's a lot easier when this might be a bit close, actually. Nah, just do that, that's fine. It's a lot easier when it's like nice big curves. Even these sort of straight points are actually very helpful in some ways. The problem comes when you have like lots of little curves, as we saw with the bionics. Meow! See, look at that bitch! Again, if you're not doing sound effects, are you really doing anything with your life? Cha-pow! Oh, look at that. Slick as a lemon. A waxy. Like, it's a wet lemon, okay? Just roll with me on this one. Let's water it up.
Asset transportation complete.
It's a blimmin' big one, isn't it? Jesus Christ. It's humongous. Well, it is a Spinosaurus. It should be. I really like how that ties in on the left as well, though. I think that's pretty cool. Right. Let me have a little think. Oh, this park is going to look so cool by the end. Nice and organic looking. Free-range Jurassic Park. Right, let's kill some water. Just in sort of random bits for now. We'll add some back in, but we're going to do another little bit of a slopey area, I think. Kind of mound in the middle. Maybe even some lower bits over there. Mix it up. Just going to stick stuff in there and see what happens, basically. Smooth it out. I think it just gives it a much more natural looking, well, look, if you've got like little dimples and stuff. And who doesn't love a dimple? Dimples are adorable. A little fairway through there. I'd really like a really small water brush so I could do like really intricate little sort of streams that go through, but not the case, unfortunately. I think that's pretty cool. Add some trees. And add a feeder, and we are Dunzel Washington. Boop. There we go. Very cool. All right. Where are you guys? You aren't even ready. Yeah. Unsurprisingly. So let's work on this little bit in the middle as well. We want a nice tiny, tiny little baby fence. And we're going to try to do this nice and... It's already wrong. What's the closest I can get this? There. All right. I'm just going to make this, and we're going to see what it looks like, and then I'll delete it, because it all turned out to be terrible. It's not perfect, but it's... No, it is bad. I don't need perfection, but I need mediocrity, you know? Give me mediocrity at least, and then I'll be happy. I've been coasting my whole life on mediocrity. That's all I need to be happy. Okay, let's just pick a very defined point and try to stick to that bit. So I've kind of got like a margin around the grass that I'm trying to match with each movement. It should, in theory, whoopsie lemony Jesus, give us a nice smooth circle. It's better. It's definitely better. This little bit over here is bugging me. I think if we can fix this bit, we're golden. Is that better? Okay, it's not perfect, but I'll take it. Right, let's get this nice and wet. Lovely, so see how it just conforms to the edge of the fence? Very cool. Boop. Nice circle in the middle. I do like the water in this game. I just wish I had more options with it. But I really like how you thin this out. You start to see the grass underneath a little bit. The water does have depth to it. It just isn't varied enough, you know? And a single beautiful tree. Very cool. All right, there we go. Waiting on Spinosaurus still? Yep, nearly done. Let's go meet our other dinosaurs whilst that is happening. They do need names. You guys very nicely did give me names for the... Sorry, I'm just distracted now. The Spinosaurus, I think, needs a little bit more water. She's proving more difficult than you would expect because of how the water works with the depth. I think that's more like it. Very cool. Okay, let's go meet our dinosaurs. You guys did give me some names for the Pachycephalosaurs and all that kind of stuff, and I do have them written down. We'll introduce those in the next episode, so please don't bother leaving names for those. But if you want to leave names for the Suchomimuses, the Baryonyxes, and the Spinosauruses, two of each, then feel free to do so in the comments down below. You edgy mother. I really want the ability to walk on my park. Let's go, let's just walk into this this bit over here kind of works with both. Oh, we've got a little hill, that's nice. Right, can we see anyone? Oh, there's a Baryonyx. Walk down here. Imagine you're walking, chuka chuka chuka, you walk like a train, okay? Baryonyx is small, isn't it? Is it smaller than Suchomimus? I think so. Definitely not that big a dinosaur. Alright, Barry, Bazza. I'm gonna call him Bazza. Bazza. Everyone's got a mate called Barry. Everyone's got a mate called Dave, according to Dave, as it happens. You are standing in a terrible position for my thumbnail. Can you please move somewhere more appropriate? Feeder needs resupply. Feeder needs resupply. Where is my lovely woman telling me just that? You know what, we can actually do this, can't we? Do we have a gate here?
Responding to resupply request.
I like that she's got a little bit of Spanish to her. You know, it makes sense. We're in Costa Rica. She should have a little bit of... Do I want to say Spanish or do I want to say Portuguese? I think I want to say Spanish. There we go, lovely. Wait, isn't this my wetlands? Oh no, this is the vivid, right? Where? How is this a wetland pattern? It's blue and purple and orange. How does that make sense? This one looks more like a wetland pattern than the other one. I think they've got those mixed up. Some of the patterns make no sense. I know they're based on like animals in that thing, but the wetland pattern should have a little bit of green to it, you know? We can even check. If we go on this and we go on jeans, wetland, Nile monitor lizard. Where's my... You don't look like a Nile monitor lizard. You look like a nerd. Oh, I love that one though. Really do. Down she goes. Oof. Oh, that's gotta hurt. That's gotta... You're gonna feel that in the morning, love. I'll tell you that much.
Asset collection request received.
I think I want more trees. Dinosaurs should feel obscured at times. And we'll probably end up getting rid of this forest, but it's just nice to cover them in forest for now, just to kind of buff up the whole botanical thingamajiggy I'm aiming for, basically. I really like how that looks. Oh, it's all swampy. That's what we're looking for, right? Swampiness. Swampiness. Oh god, I'm such a child. Right, let's get the other Spino moving.
Acknowledging asset collection request.
I love it when she talks to me like that. She knows just how to get me. See one on the way? Yeah, there it goes. Noble as ever. A beautiful, majestic, limp creature. Right! These were the main two ideas I had, so I am open to suggestions what you guys think we should do with the next ones. Somebody suggested like a Morrison Formation themed thing. I don't want to go too hard in on that kind of stuff because I do want to do like I want to do a whole park themed around that kind of idea, you know, dinosaurs that would have naturally lived together. I do want to build an entire park with that idea, so we're going to hold off on that, but I'm open to other suggestions. Anything that would fit a What is this? This is nonsense. I will not stand for this nonsense here. There we go. Anything that would fit like a botanical garden themed park, really. Anything that has that kind of rainforest natural... I love how that looks. That is very cool. I'm so proud of myself. I'm so clever. sorry. We still need to do the monorail, actually. We'll do that at the end. Yeah, so any ideas? We've got loads of space to play with. All this room down here. All this room over here on the left-hand side as well. I do like the idea, and I mentioned this before, of having like an area where you walk across a chasm, but you walk like this over here with the water, but imagine instead of water, you're walking across a chasm, basically. I wonder if we do a path. I'm just going to try this out super quickly. I've never tried this out. Let me do a little experiment here. Right. Path. Fence.
Asset delivered.
Do it on both sides just in case. Okay. And now when we drop it down, does it take everything with it, basically? Yeah, that's a shame. Okay. But we can still do that. That is still viable. Unfortunately, I don't really like the depth system in this game in terms of land. You can see we've always got these. It'd be nice to get it nice and straight, you know, that's just like a flat edge. But I mean, this does look more natural. That's got, definitely got a very natural sort of appeal. Little tree on there. There we go. Made all the difference in the world, folks. Made all the difference in the world. Right, there's our Spino. You liking your new exhibit, friendo? You're not in the water enough. Where's your friend? Your friend's got it. Your friend's got it made. There you go. There. You just knew, didn't you, pal? You just knew. That's what I wanted for the thumbnail. Look at that. Beautiful. Nice to maybe get more of the exhibit in, but he's facing the wrong direction. No, it's fine. Well, there we go. Let's have a little wander through. Pretend we're a human. Pretend I'm a human. I promise I'm not a robot or an alien. Just wandering through. This is as close as we can get. Wandering through. Pretend I didn't just smack my head on the fence. You do have dinosaurs on your dinosaur tour, right? Okay, let's carry on going. See if we can spot anything. Ah, on the right hand side we have ourselves. Very cool. Okay, Suchomimus. Nice little bit here. If we had some benches and stuff, this is where I'd put them. And maybe like a thing in the middle, like a shop or something. But we don't have those options quite yet. Well, obviously there are shops, but none that I'd want to put in here. On the left, there we go. We see our Spinos. And let's go find ourselves Baryonyx over the little hill, which we're going to keep. It's kind of like a little racetrack. Meow! We're not the most official park in the world. We're just a nice park. Barry. Where's Bazaar at? Bazarat sounds like a Cthulian, Lovecraftian god. There he is, that's Bazza. He's approaching. Quiet, all of you. He's approaching the human. Where's he going? There's something just really nice and natural looking about that. Like, even, I know there's a fence there, but how you can just see this being an actual park, in a way, you know? Just kind of doing his own thing. There's a lot of problems I have with the behaviours and AI of the dinosaurs in this game, but if you don't look at them too long and you just observe them every now and again, they do look awesome at times. They really do. They just feel alive. I really like it. They could definitely be better, and I hope they get better, but they are still pretty cool. Right, we're going to end it there. Thank you for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. That whole area has been complete amundoed. That's English, don't question me. And I'll see you lovely folks then. Leave some suggestions in the comments down below. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. It really helps me out. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Quick little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.